Hey folks, welcome to Fails and Flails. Today in this video I'm going to be doing a quick rundown of everything that we know about the upcoming new edition of D&D, even though I am a little bit late, but maybe you're late hearing about it, or maybe you just want a different opinion, because I am also going to be giving a few things that I might be expecting and that the community is interested in seeing in the next edition of D&D, so let's hop right into it.
Come on. Ah.
The first thing to note is that it will be dropping in 2024, which will be in line with the 50th anniversary of Dungeons & Dragons, which is pretty cool and honestly makes sense. I know a lot of people were anticipating a new edition to come out around this time, as it is about the exact same spacing as previous editions have been released from each other as well. In the meantime, they said that they are going to be adding three new settings to the official settings of Dungeons & Dragons. They did confirm Ravenloft for that one, and they said the other two were classics as well, so this might be Spelljammer or possibly Dark Sun, although that one might be a little bit of a risky take. And also for those settings, they said one would be released in 2022, so just in a few months here, and then the second one will be coming in 23, and probably the third one coming in 24 when the new edition is released. Now, an important thing to note here is that they did say it will be compatible with D&D 5e, so it's probably not going to be D&D 6th edition, even if they do call that. I imagine much more of like a D&D 5.5, which is kind of what I expected, especially with the massive popularity of D&D 5e. I don't really imagine them just reimagining the whole game or just, changing the mechanics all over again, just kind of building onto it, maybe making some minor tweaks, which can easily be adapted from D&D 5e as it is now. Of course, with the release of a new edition, they're going to be coming out with new Player's Handbook, a new Dungeon Master's Guide, and new Monster Manuals as well. They did say that they're going to start using a new format for those, and I will actually get those to a minute. But if you take nothing else away from this video, this next part is probably the most important, is as they are finishing up development of the next edition of D&D, they are going to be putting out a number of surveys to the fandom of D&D. And so if there's something that you really want to see in the next editions, a change, an addition, anything like that, make sure you keep an eye out for those surveys so you can have an impact on its development. Now, along with the announcement of the new edition of D&D, they also announced a new product, which is going to be Mordenkainen Presents Monsters of the Multiverse. This is set to drop on January 25th of 2022. It does obviously have the alt covers, although they're going with like a more white cover for this one compared to usually the darker ones that they had in the past for alt covers. The big thing to note here is that when it's first dropping, it is only available in a 3-pack, which includes Tasha's Cauldron of Everything and Xanathar's Guide to Everything. So you cannot buy the book alone when it first drops, and then I think a few months later they will sell the book just on it by itself. So if you already have those two, and I do, there's really no point in buying those books again, even if you just want the alt covers. It's kind of up to you, but I'm definitely not wasting money to buy two books that I already own again just to get a book that I don't own. Now, they do plan on rolling out some new changes in this Mordenkainen's and Tasha's and Xanathar's for the new release, and this has to do with the new format that they were talking about including. This is to basically simplify monster stat blocks. A large part of that is also for monster spells. They no longer have the former list of spells and spell slots that they have. For this one, it basically just wraps those spell slots into actions that they can take. So it's going to be a lot simpler. You don't need to have multiple books open just to run a single monster, which I definitely like. That being said, it does sound like Mordenkainen's Presents the Monsters of the Multiverse is basically just a republishing of a lot of monsters that already exist in the other books. It says it's going to be over 250 monsters and over 30 playable races. So for the races, they might make some modifications there, including some of the changes that we saw in some of the other splat books like Tasha's there. However, because it is just a republishing of things that already exist in the other books, it does kind of seem like a little bit of a cash grab, but I mean, you can't really blame them because you know thousands of people will buy it. Although, backtracking a little bit there as I just double checked my notes there, they do plan on including some new abilities, some new balancing for some of the monsters, maybe some of the races as well, and all new art, so that in itself may be worth buying. So really it is up to you. And the last bit of information that we got from the announcement was a nod towards Boo, the miniature giant space hamster, which I think is a pretty good indication that we're likely going to be seeing a a 5e or 5.5e adaptation for Spelljammer, which I think will be pretty cool to see in the future. Now on to what the community wants, what I'm expecting for basically the new edition, how they're going to rebalance it. There are quite a bit of opinions. You know, I talked with a number of people, you know, what they're interested in, what they really want, what they absolutely don't want. So I'm going to dive into that here, with the first one being common verbiage among just throughout the playbook. There are a number of things where you have a melee weapon attack versus an attack with a melee weapon. There are things like monks. Technically, their fists are weapons, but they cannot smite with their fists through the paladin's ability because, according to Jeremy Crawford, it is not considered a weapon. So things like that. Also, you have things like once per day, once per long rest, you know, at dawn. I know for some things that's just because obviously if it's an item that recharges at dawn, it's not something that can take a long rest, but just having all these different verbiages tends to make things a little bit more murkier. I know they did try to clear that up in one of the recent splat books. Just having common verbiage throughout the entirety of the system is definitely going to be a lot more beneficial for people who aren't as set on just reading through all of the rule books. The next big change that I would especially like to see is a change from classes and everything being based on 8 encounters per day to being based on 3 or 4 encounters per day. And I honestly think that this is why marshals feel so underpowered in D&D 5e. And that's because, you know, wizards and classes with spell class or spell slots, whatever, you know, just have a whole bunch of spell slots. And some groups, like one group that I'm currently playing with, we will maybe have one combat encounter per session, and so like per day, which means you know, spellcasters, they can just blow all their slots and, you know, absolutely wipe the floor with it. Whereas martial classes, you know, they're gonna keep hitting, and that's kind of the big thing that I think 5e was supposed to be balanced around, is 8 encounters per day. In that case, you know, a spellcaster may only be able to cast 1 or 2 spells per encounter, or even less at lower levels if they want to be able to cast spells for the entire day, whereas the martial class can just keep on hitting and just keeps on hitting more and harder. So yeah, definitely, I don't want to say necessarily debuffing spellcasters, but maybe buffing marshals a little bit more. And that actually leads into the next one here, which is more abilities for marshals. You know, for casters, they have in-combat abilities and out-of-combat abilities and just utility spells and all this thing. And so while they're already better at both of those things, marshals kind of just kind of fall to the wayside there. You know, they can be really good in combat, obviously, but then out of combat, if it's not involving a strength check or anything, then they're probably not going to be very useful for it. And there obviously are ways to make up for that. But you know, when a wizard can just cast a spell and immediately overcome the situation, then it obviously makes it so, again, marshals just kind of fall to the wayside. The next big change that a lot of people in the community want to see is a total reworking of the feats, as well as their connection to ASIs. I know a lot of people don't like that whenever you get an ASI, you have to choose between, you know, getting that +1 bonus to a skill or getting a really cool feat. And obviously, a lot of people usually go with the feat. Some people just want the bigger numbers. It really depends. So a lot of people want to see that just separated, making feats a non-optional rule and actually integrated into the game. And then also just a total, like I said before, a reworking of them, where because there are some feats that are totally useless and there are some that are just completely overpowered. You know, look at the actor feat. It's really great for roleplay, but if you're in a combat-heavy game, then it's pretty much useless. Or the weapon master feat that allows you to gain 4 proficiencies. There are very special and, you know, solitary occasions where that would actually be useful, and most of them would just be hand waved by a DM. So that feat compared to, you know, great weapon master or sharpshooter or a polearm sentinel combo, you know, those are 4 feats that you're going to see at least one of them in nearly every campaign just because of how overpowered they are. So just maybe spreading that out a little bit, like I said, making feats integrated into the system would definitely, I believe, make the game a lot better. One of the last things that people wanted for a new edition would be more hashed out exploration mechanics. Right now, it's pretty simple for the players. It doesn't really give any hints as how to do it for the Dungeon Master, though. It just kind of, you know, hand waves it, says, oh yeah, you know, just go about it, make them make a roll or whatever, but it doesn't really give any guide to, you know, what should they discover if they roll however well. Do they just know everything in the area? And so a little bit more explanation or just set rules or guidelines on how to do that, I think it's going to help a lot of DMs make a little bit more use out of actual exploration, which is supposed to be one of the three pinnacles of D&D, aside from role play and combat. On top of that, a lot of people also want to see a reworking of the Dungeon Master's Guide and make it less of a reference and more of an actual guide to, you know, being a Dungeon Master. Maybe a little bit of like hand-holding, like, you know, this are some ways that you can run this a little bit better, instead of just, you know, being a reference for more rules and, you know, magic items. The last one is people want to see more difficult monsters that aren't just meat bags. For a lot of them, you know, a higher level monster just means it has more HP, a higher AC, so you're hitting less often and takes more hits to take down. I would definitely like to see some more unique abilities, maybe that are focused around movement or just causing discord in the battlefield, or similar to D&D 3.5, dragons getting their breath attack immediately once they become bloodied. Things like that. Special abilities that trigger at certain points, or even like a boss's final form. Anything like that would make it more interesting without just increasing their HP. Let me know down in the comments section what exactly you want to see in the next edition of D&D. Let me know if you filled out any surveys or if you plan on doing so to try to impact the direction that the next D&D edition is going to go. And you know, just anything else you want to drop down in the comments section, go ahead, let me know. I'll be sure to respond. Don't forget to subscribe, share this video with your friends, and you all have a great day. Thank you for watching.